Hello and welcome to the fourth of the tutorials on how to use your WordPress website. In this tutorial, we'll look on how to update the menu, which is this portion. We'll look at the contact form, which is this portion, and we'll look at the widgets, which are what you can add to this sidebar here. So first we'll look at the menu. The menu is really actually quite easy to update. If we just go up here to the shortcut to getting into your WordPress editing, there is a shortcut to menus. It is also found under the Appearance tab. Your main menu is called the main menu, conveniently enough. And if you want to just reorder things how they appear in the menu, it really is just a matter of dragging and dropping these things here. Let's say I wanted to put self-development counseling up to the top of the list. All I have to do is grab it and move it and hit save. And then if we wanted to go over here and look at that, I'm going to just open it in a new tab to make it easier. If I look under here, now self-development counseling is at the top of the list. But let's say I wanted to put some of this grouped together a little bit more. Let's say I wanted to put suicide counseling and bereavement counseling together under one category. I could just easily take suicide counseling and put it, just see how if I hover it just a little bit to the side of bereavement counseling, see how it's just a little indented. If I hit save menu now, I go back and take a look at this. If I refresh that. Then if I go over here and look at counselor, now bereavement counselor has suicide counseling as a subcategory of it. But let's say we decided we didn't like that. So all I have to do is move it over a little bit. Now it is just a subset of counselor. It's all a subset of counselor. So let's save that menu. Let's say I wanted to add a new thing. I've made a new section to my website and I want to add it to the menu. If you made a new page, it'll show up over here in this pages. And let's say we wanted to add this page called articles to your menu. All you would have to do is say add to menu and it'll show up here at the bottom. And then if I want to reorder it, let's just say I put it up here above contact. Then that's where it's going to show up. So let's save that menu. Go take a look. If I refresh this page, there's the menu of articles that I just added. If I want to delete what I just made there, all I have to do is select it and hit remove. There's a little button here to open that, each one. If I wanted to make a custom link that was, for example, to an external website, let's say you're working on a conference and you want to have a link on your menu directly to their conference, all you have to do is put the link, the full URL right here, and put what the name is right there and add that to the menu. So I think that's all you need to know about menus. Let's look at the contact form. So the contact form is over here on the left. Oh, it's telling me it knows that I made a change and I did not hit save menu. So let's stay on the page and hit save menu. Now it'll let me leave that page without reminding me that I need to do that. So now we're on the contact form tab and we only have one contact form on this website. So we want to select it. This is the code for the way it shows up. If, for example, we wanted to add a little text, you can just type it right at the beginning. Let's say you wanted to add your phone number. You could just add it right here. Just like that. And we hit save. Let's just use this tab to go over here to the contact form. And here's that text that I just added there. Now let's say you wanted to add a little, let's say you wanted to add a way for people to upload images to you or to upload information. That's very simple to do if you just want to generate a tag over here, a new tag. Let's say you wanted to generate a file upload tag. So it makes this little piece of short code right here. And it says copy this code and paste it into the form on the left. So I'm going to copy it And I'm going to put it right over here. And then, so that adds it to the form, but that doesn't necessarily add it to the email that it's going to send to you. So it has this other little reminder here, and put this code into the file attachments field below. So we're going to copy that code there, and we're going to scroll down here. Here's the mail that it's going to send you, and we're going to add it to this file attachments. Now this little piece right here is nice. This is what it, how it formats the mail that it's going to send. So if you want it to change the address, you just change that right there. If you want it to come from somebody else or change the subject or add additional information so you always know it's coming from your website, or if you want to change what the body of the message is, it's right over here. Whatever you add to this section will be added to every email that is sent to and from your website. So once we've made all those changes, let's just hit save. Let's go over here and take a little look. I'm going to refresh this page. So here's still where I've added the phone number. And then down here is an upload file. So all you have to do is choose the file from your website, from your computer. And now if I hit send, it would also be sending this file to you as well. So now the last thing that we want to look at is we want to look at the widgets. It's a very odd name for adding special little tools to your website, primarily in the sidebar and or in the footer area. So the main one you want to use is the sidebar. Here, let's just go back here and take a look so you can see what I'm talking about. This area right here is the sidebar. And if you want to add things or rearrange the order of these things, it's very easy to do here. Let's say you wanted to have recent comments at the very top. I would just drag and drop that to the top. And then if I go over here, take a look and refresh this page. Now recent comments is at the very top of that sidebar. Let's say I want to add a piece of text. Let's say I'm doing something special, you know, have a special running or a little conference coming up. You can just add a text block over here. You can give it a title. And let's say, hit save, and let's go take a look at that. Refresh. Here is that text that we just added. Now let's say you wanted to make this into a link so that it took you to another place in your website or took you to another location. There is an easy way to do that. Unfortunately, you can't just copy paste the link here. You need to add the full HTML code in order to make it into a link. So I've added a shortcode page for you to have all of that information kind of easily accessible within your website just for you to copy paste. So if you go to all pages and you scroll down to shortcodes, you can just hit edit as a way to look at it. Here are some sample shortcodes that are being used on your website. So this is the one that is the full HTML in order to turn something into a link. So I can just copy this. And now let's go back over here to Appearance Widgets. And let's look at this. So here's this upcoming promotion. And I'm going to paste this href. So it's caret A href, standing for anchor hypertext reference, equals, and then there's the full URL address. For example, this one is just happens to be going to a page on your website. I could copy paste any URL right into that section if I wanted. And then you see here there's the end quote and the end caret. And then this text right here is whatever the text will show up. So let's just call this the biofeedback link. And then there's the end caret here. So this is end caret slash A that tells it that that's the end of the link. So let's just hit save. And let's go take a look at that. So now you see it, the text that I wrote inside there, biofeedback link, is right here. And if I hover over it, it just knows that it's a link. And if I click on it, it takes it to whatever address I added in there, which happened to just be this page on your website. So that's a really easy way to add, well, I wouldn't say easy. That is a way to add a link to the sidebar, or actually any place on your website. If you really want to add a link, let's say into a photo or into the homepage slideshow, you just need to copy this whole Ahref code, and whatever you put inside there then will take you to wherever you want to go. But let's say we don't really want to have this, so we're just going to hit delete because we don't really need that, and we're going to move these things back around in the order we want, and now we're good to go. So I think that's all I need to tell you about menus, contact forms, and widgets. Thank you for listening. Have fun editing your website. Bye-bye.